In this problem, we're asked to use the integral test to test the convergence of this series. Now, this series is actually very easy to deal with using a direct comparison to the convergent series 1 over n squared, because these terms are smaller than the terms of that convergent series. And yet, we're asked to use the integral test, so let's see what it looks like. So I take the integral of the related function 1 over x squared plus x dx on 1 to infinity, and I'm hoping to find a finite number out of this. And we're already given the clue that we should use partial fractions for this. So I factor the denominator. And then I make a partial fractions proposal. And this is just two linear factors, so I just need two pieces in my proposal, each with a constant in the numerator, and one of those linear factors in the denominator. And I'm going to clear out all the denominators by multiplying by x times x plus 1. And when I distribute that x times x plus 1 to this a containing term, the x's are going to cancel, and I have a times the quantity x plus 1. Similar story for the second term. The x plus 1 cancels, leaving me with an x. And this is one that I can do quickly by just subbing in different values of x. If I plug in x equals 0, then the b term dies, and I get 1a. So I get 1 equals 1a, or a equals 1, and that's done. If I plug in x equals negative 1, then the a containing term dies, and it gives me 1 equals b times negative 1, or negative b, which means b is negative 1. Now I can rewrite my integral with this fraction split into pieces. And I found that a was 1, so I have a 1 over x. And b was negative 1, so I have minus 1 over x plus 1 dx. Now, both of these pieces have guessable antiderivatives. It's just the natural log of the absolute value of the denominator. But we're dealing only with positive x's, so I don't have to worry about that absolute value part. And I could write it this way, that I'm evaluating natural log x minus natural log x plus 1 on the interval 1 to infinity. Now, in a case where I could just sub in infinity and get an unambiguous answer, that would be fine. But in this case, that would give me the natural log of infinity minus the natural log of infinity plus 1, which is like an infinity minus infinity indeterminate form. So I'm going to be a little more formal with it and actually express that infinite limit as a limit. So in my upper limit, I have the limit as x goes to infinity, natural log x minus natural log x plus 1. And then in my lower limit, I have minus natural log of 1 minus natural log of 2. Then to get clarity on my limit, I'm going to use the properties of logs to combine these two terms, and I get the natural log of x over x plus 1. And then in my second piece, the natural log of 1 is 0, and I get the negative of negative natural log 2, in other words, plus natural log 2. Then to explore this limit, I could move the limit inside the natural log function. And you can either handle that limit informally by saying the highest power of x dominates the numerator and denominator. In other words, the 1 is negligible and I end up with x over x, or just 1 out of that. A little more formally, I can divide the top and bottom by the highest power of x. So I'll go ahead and show that method. And that gives me a 1 in the numerator, and a 1 plus 1 over x in the denominator. And then we say that it's clear that the limit as x goes to infinity of 1 over x is 0. So my limit turns into just 1, and if I have the natural log of 1, that gives me 0. So this whole thing vanishes, and I'm left with just the natural log of 2. Now the integral test says if I perform this integral and I get a finite number out of it, then it shows the convergence of the series. So the sum of 1 over n squared plus n converges, and we're done. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.